Yeah, and Jason, as far as we know, this is the store, the earliest opening here on Black Friday, and it has paid off. There are hundreds and hundreds of people waiting in line. This line actually spreads down the store, back around the side. Probably still more than 1,000 people in line, and there have been people sadly coming out with carts full of toys. Here's someone where someone is going to be very happy come Christmas Day when they open up all of those presents. This was a scene when the stores opened their door at 9 o'clock just about an hour ago, people giving up their holiday night to take advantage of some of these early Black Friday specials, heading inside, going for their favorite toy, and trying to get that before it gets snapped up. You know, some people who are probably watching this at home are thinking that these people are just out of their mind, but for others, this has all become a holiday tradition. The sidewalk outside the Best Buy store in Greenfield has turned into a tent city as shoppers get in position for Black Friday deals. For the fifth year in a row, Joe and John Butchley are at the head of the line. For the construction worker brothers, this is their new Thanksgiving tradition.
He's my only brother, and it makes it kind of fun. Mom even gets into it. We just finished Thanksgiving dinner just a few minutes ago, so hey, I guess it's something for us to do.
The pair got here Tuesday afternoon to make sure they were up front. Their list this year of must-haves includes a $200 TV.
It's a 42-inch sharp and laptops and tablets and all kinds of fun stuff. I mean, it's worth it.
Most people are prepared for the wait and the cold with tents, blankets, and portable heaters. First-time Black Friday shopper Juan Rojo came after the Packer game and finds himself way back in the line.
I didn't know what time I should come or anything, so I don't know.
Do you wish you'd gotten here earlier now?
Yeah, I wish I'd gotten here way earlier.
Getting there early was not a problem for Michelle Schultz. For most of the day, she was the only person in line at the Target at 27th and Layton until her cousin joined her.
And we promised each other last year that we would do it too, the moment that we walked out of the store. So now it's, I guess, our family tradition.
In the spirit of giving, the two are there for one thing and one thing only, a TV for Michelle's parents.
Get in line and get the TV for my parents, not for me. I'm not getting anything for myself.
As we are back here live out Toys R Us, it's probably safe to say people here are not getting anything for themselves either. So what they do is they're bringing people up, queuing them in at about 50 at a time. And then when enough people leave, they send that 50 in and the line just continues going and going. At this point, it looks like it could probably go all night long. Well, some of these people are probably heading from here to some of those other stores that are opening in just a few hours. You know, if you are heading out and about, whether it's tonight or this weekend, you are by no means alone. The National Retail Federation is estimating 152 million people will be getting out and about and shopping and spending some of their hard-earned money this Black Friday weekend. Reporting live on the South Side, Brendan Conway, WISN 12 News.